Hey guys, Nick here, and in today's video of Vienna Symphonic Library's Synchronized Special Editions, I want to show you how these magical libraries are working in a context of a hybrid sci-fi piece of music for a video game. This here, what I have for you, is a piece of music that I composed for a video game called Starpoint Gemini 2, which I scored a couple of months ago. And what I have here is my main symphony orchestra, which is purely 100% synchronized special editions, various libraries of synchronized special editions. And I wanted to show you here how these instruments blend well with other third-party libraries, hybrid, you know, sound design stuff, and external synthesizers that I have, since this is a hybrid sci-fi piece of music. We got symphony orchestra, we got synthesizers, we got sound designed percussion and stuff like that. So let's play the piece of music first, and then I'm gonna explain to you how I got these results. So without further ado, here we go. And there you have it. So this is obviously a sci-fi thing. I really love composing music like this, and I've said this countless times before. What I love about Vienna Symphonic Library's Synchronized Special Edition is that you don't have to, you know, tweak them too much. You don't have to fuss about, you know, blending them into the mix. They are recorded and they are edited and they are processed so well that the only thing you have to do here is just sit down, you play your music, you compose your stuff, and everything will work itself out in the background. And that is why I love using them over and over again. So I got everything hosted here in my Vienna Ensemble, which is a free host application for Vienna Symphonic Library's instruments. I've talked about this in my template setup video, so go check that one out before. What I have also here, everything is also, like I said, hosted in Synchron Player, which is Vienna Symphonic Library's free sample player for Vienna Symphonic Library's instruments. And session-wise, what I used here is that there are no woodwinds here, so I have only my brass and my strings and my orchestral percussions and my choirs and piano that are layered on top of these these external instruments that I have. So, but main libraries that I used here are volume 1 and volume 1 plus. So there are two, which is kind of like volume 1 is your main symphony orchestra, standard orchestral sections with articulations, and this piano here, which is a synchron piano, is also from the volume 1, but volume 1 plus gives you extended articulations for the already existing instruments of volume 1. Okay, so what I also used is the volume 3. Okay, so volume 3 is the appassionata strings. So my template is set up in a modular way, so that I can always, and what I love, and I've mentioned this, what I love about Vienna instruments is that they all have their key switches, their controls, and everything set up for every instrument and for every library to be the same. So you just replace things that you wanna use and you get a different sound, different result. So my main template is always loaded with volume 1. So for example, strings here, my violins are from my volume 1 and volume 1 plus. But what I have, what I did is that I replaced the string sections from volume 1 with the string sections from volume 3, the appassionata strings, which gives you this larger than life Hollywood sound, huge sections, sounds very, very cinematic, really lush sounding thanks to all the tiny little processings of the synchron player in the background. So what I have here, for example, my violin's first longs, as you can see here, I have the appassionata first violins, 20 first violins, really sounding huge. I'm using these legatos here. I'm key switching my velocities here, and I have a velocity crossfade set up at MIDI CC1, so I can dynamically blend my dynamic levels of the violins and all of my long articulations. And I have my short articulations on a separate MIDI channel to trigger them via key velocity. But if you want to have a more, you know, approach of like a single instrument per MIDI channel, you can, and you like using your velocity keyboard for short articulations and MIDI CC like mod wheel for dynamics of longer articulations, there is in the user's manual, there's an option where it tells you how to set up on a MIDI CC28 to turn on and off the velocity crossfade. So you have, like, when it's turned off, you have your velocity triggered with your keyboard velocity. And when it's turned on, it, you know, it basically crossfades with your MIDI CC control. So this is a really handy option if you want to use and a MIDI channel per instrument. But I like having these separate because when I render stuff, I send to game developers to have stems of short and long articulations of my orchestral sections. Now, even though these are sounding really huge, I wanted them to sound precise and presentful. So when it comes to my short articulations here with same thing with violins and my violas, as you can see here, I have violas one short and viola two short. So viola one short are my appassionata strings, my appassionata violas, and my viola two shorts are my dimension strings. And now the dimension strings are your volume five. So dimension strings give you this next level of control of layering when they're really cool for layering on top of your other existing libraries, because it gives you more of a, especially on short articulations where this is very important for, you know, giving you this really, you know, snappy attack, especially when it comes to like pizzicatos. And on my short notes, I have my, you know, staccatos here and everything. And I have controls like smaller group section here where I really can have a lot more dynamic control and more, you know, more nuances to add on top of the existing big string sections. So basically, I'm gonna show this to you how this all sounds. Now, for example, these are the short strings from Appassionata by themselves. These are the dimension strings. You can really hear the attack on the bow, where that it's a lot more more aggressive and more present, more present. So layered together, you know, you have these, you know, you have this big sound and you have this smaller sound, which gives you a lot more control to it. So two of them together really blend really nicely. And with these other instruments where, I mean, short articulations really, especially for faster parts of music, you really want to have this control and without all the washy reverb and stuff like that. So it's really handy to have dimension strings as a layer on top of your existing string libraries. Same thing goes with my brass. So I have my volume one horns here. They're playing not the shorts, but the long ones. So you can give more nuances to even the long articulation. So my horns here are from my volume one. I have horn two longs, which are my dimension horns. I mean, these are dimension brass, which are volume six of the synchronized special edition. So how these horns are sounding, these are just, I have my key switches here. So this is the legatos of the volume one horns. Okay, and this is the volume this is the dimension brass horns. Okay, so two of them together are sounding really full and thick, because volume one gives it a nice open, nice roomy sound, which is very warm, but the dimension horns, dimension brass library, gives you a more aggressive and a sharper sound. So two of them together, it's like, you know, having this really nice big horn sound. Vienna Choir sounds pretty sweet, and it comes in volume 4. Yeah, it's volume 4, which is special woodwinds, choirs, and solo voices. So special woodwinds, I have them in my template, which is like the bass, flute, the additional bassoon, and stuff like that. And choirs, you have an entire choir section, and you have separate sections of like sopranos, altos, tenors, basses, and you have individual soloists, like the solo soprano, solo alto, solo tenor, solo bass singer. So you can always have them, you know, if you want more control, you can have these. But I have my choir here as a more of a synth, as a more of a pad layer, but I wanted it to sound natural. So this is the choir. Last thing here is the piano, which is a synchron piano that comes bundled together with volume 1, but you don't play it inside of a synchron player. It has its own separate sample player, which is called synchron pianos, and this is where you have your controls. I have it set to ambience settings, so it, you know, sits in the mix and sounds cinematic in a way. So this is how the piano sounds. I'm not having any fancy piano performances, it's just a melody, but I just want to show you how nice this piano sounds. It fades off nicely because it's the end of the track and everything. And this has been the Vienna Symphonic Library special edition synchronized new collection inside of a synchron player. You've heard it all here, folks. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, enjoy. Check out the Vienna Symphonic Library synchronized special editions and have fun with it.